Welcome to the fifth meeting of Session 6 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. And before we move to the first item on the agenda, I'd like to remind everyone present to switch their mobile phones to silent. The first item of business is to decide whether to take item 5 in private. Is the committee content to take this item in private? Yep. Under agenda item number 2, we're considering instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. No points have been raised on the following draft instruments. The local authority, capital finance and accounting, Scotland coronavirus amendment regulations 2022, the non-domestic rates valuation rule modification Scotland regulations 2022, the community care, personal care and nursing care Scotland amendment regulations 2022, the legal aid and advice and assistance financial limit Scotland amendment regulations 2022, the social security uprating Scotland order 2022, the Social Security Uprating Miscellaneous Amendment Scotland Regulations 2022 and the Digital Government Scottish Bodies Regulations 2022. Is the committee content with these instruments?
Yeah.
Under agenda item number 3, we're considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. An issue has been raised on one of these instruments, which is SSI 2022-35, the Sea Fish Prohibition Fishing Firth of Clyde number 2 Order 2022. The Sea Fish Conservation Act 1967 allows Scottish ministers to prohibit by order sea fishing in specified waters. This instrument reduces the size of the cod spawning closure at areas in which fishing by any method is prohibited within two areas in, sorry, of the Firth of Clyde mapped in the schedule to the instrument. The aim is to protect cod in the Firth of Clyde from fishing mortality during the spawning period for a recognised spawning ground. The prohibition applies to British fishing boats from the 14th of February until the 30th of April during both 2022 and 2023. Under section 28.2 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010, instruments subject to the negative procedure are required to be laid at least 28 days before they come into force, not counting recess periods of more than 4 days. In correspondence with the presiding officer, the Scottish Government explained that they have recently reconsidered and reduced the extent of the areas for closure. As the cod closure begins on the 14th of February, it's necessary for the amendments to come into force on the 12th of February, which breaches the 28-day rule. And with that, I'm going to open up for any points or questions before I continue. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament under reporting ground J in relation to its failure to lay the instrument in accordance with laying requirements under the 2010 Act?
Yeah.
And at the same time, is the committee content with the Scottish Government's explanation provided for the breach of this laying requirement?
Yeah.
Okay. And thank you for that. And finally, no points have been raised on the following instruments, SSIs 2022, 28, 30 and 34. But and also no points have been raised on SSI 2022-26. But I believe Mr Sweeney would like to comment on it.
Thank you, Convener. Just a general point about the nature of this particular SSI in relation to speed limit adjustments on the Central Scotland motorway network. Though this particular instrument relates to slip roads, there is a wider practice whereby speed limit changes to the main trunk road network isn't generally consulted on a public basis. And I think that would benefit from wider public consultation, particularly given recent reports of the significant effects of noise pollution, particularly in central Glasgow, because of the motorway network. For example, Charing Cross, it's been reported that noise pollution is equivalent to standing on the runway at Glasgow Airport. So there are significant environmental effects that affect the general public, and I think that a practice should be drawn whereby any changes and adjustments to the speed limits should be considered as a general public consultation rather than simply a closed shop between councils and the emergency services. So perhaps it might be something for the lead committee to take into consideration going forward.
Okay, thanks for that, Mr Sweeney. Any other comments? Graham?
Thanks, Convener. I think Mr Sweeney makes a very good point here. Too often, changes like this are done, and I apologise to anyone watching, my face is probably bathed in sunlight at the moment. But too often changes like this are just done between public bodies. You know, it could be Transport Scotland or councils, police, and the public don't get to hear about any of it. So I think Mr. Sweeney makes a very good point and one that is worth highlighting to the lead committee.
Thank you for that, Graham. So I think with that, I think as we will notify the lead committee of the points raised, also in the report that we produce as well, if that's okay with yourselves. Okay. Okay. So now with that, are the committee content with these instruments?
Yes.
Okay. Under agenda item number 4, we're considering an instrument subject to the laid only procedure. No points have been raised on SSI 2022-23. Is the committee content with this instrument?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And with that, I will move the committee into private. Thank you.